Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, fight fans. Welcome back to our 50-50 series on Anthony Joshua and Andy Ruiz. I believe it's a 50-50 fight. So we have a two-part series breaking down Andy Ruiz and Anthony Joshua and the three reasons why each particular fighter wins. And we're going to start with Andy Ruiz. And Andy Ruiz Jr., you know, there's three particular reasons why Andy Ruiz Jr. can win this rematch and will win this rematch in that regard. And the first reason has to be his hand speed. Andy Ruiz Jr. has a top level and elite level hand speed, and that's caused Anthony Joshua fits in the first fight, kept him off balance. Was one of the main reasons why Anthony Joshua got dropped and hurt is because Andy Ruiz is able to throw a flurry of punches at Anthony Joshua that he's not always readily prepared for, and his hand speed is going to continue to be a significant problem and hurdle for Anthony Joshua to overcome. And hand speed is just one of the top level problems Anthony Joshua will face. The second reason is power. You know, a lot of people look at Andy Ruiz Jr. and doesn't think of him as an elite level power puncher. And you know, Andy Ruiz Jr. has respectable power. Andy Ruiz Jr. Is a heavyweight, so you know, of course he has good punch. But at the end of the day, he really has more than respectable power than most people will think, because you know, there's a reason Joseph Parker stayed on the back foot the entire fight when he fought him. There's a reason why he hurt Anthony Joshua in the fight, because he does have respectable power. You know, when he fought Evander Holyfield in a sparring matchup, Evander Holyfield stated that he warned the world that, hey, Andy Ruiz Jr. has a lot of power, that everyone needs to be on alert, be on the lookout. Andy Ruiz Jr. is no joke, and he has a very sizable and powerful punch. And Andy Ruiz Jr.'s power has shown to put Anthony Joshua down four times before in the original match. So just imagine what he can do if he lands clean and consistently in a rematch. So Andy Ruiz Jr.'s power has to be one of the reasons why he should be able to defeat Anthony Joshua in the rematch. And the third reason is the fact that Andy Ruiz Jr. fought in Macau, China. You know, Macau, China is across the world. It's you know, different food, time zone change, a lot of inconveniences for Andy Ruiz Jr. And he's shown that he can overcome those by fighting in Macau, China multiple times early in his career. And now he's going to Saudi Arabia to face Anthony Joshua, and it's going to be a lot of the same things. You know, traveling across seas, you know, changing food, changing diet, changing time zones, you know, just the uncomfortable, you know, ness of being somewhere that's not home. And so this is something that Andy Ruiz Jr. has experience with. This is something Andy Ruiz Jr. has proven to be successful with in the past, and I believe that is one of the main reasons why Andy Ruiz Jr. will be able to adapt to the extreme conditions in Saudi Arabia and come out victorious in a rematch. But once again, it's the 50-50 series with the IBFP. Please share, like, and you must absolutely subscribe.